All right, Christianen, we're going to go over drafting. We have Tender 15 here. We've got the new engine 9. We're first going to start by setting up the Porter tank. We're going to talk about how we set it up, where we set it up, and then we'll go from there on how to actually pull the draft in flow water. All right, here we go. So here we got Tender 15. On the side of Tender 15, we have a Porter tank. This is the only Porter tank we've got in the system. So if you are going to do drafting operations and you're not going to get a static water source, such as a stream, a swimming pool, something of that nature, you need Tender 15 or one of our mutual aid agencies to bring one of their tenders and a Porter tank on the out to get the operation going. So the Porter tank's mounted on the side. It's got a basic mechanical drop down holder here that's going to let you let go. All we're going to do is undo these locks. I got someone on the other end. We're going to lay this down nice and easy, not pinching any fingers. Make sure your fingers aren't under the tank because it will slide down. And then this is really just a two-person operation. We're just going to lift out. The top comes out first. You lift the bottom out from the brackets. There we go. Come over to our engine. We're going to set this up next to the BIV. Okay? A couple key things before you set this up. Do not get in a hurry when you're doing this. Set up your Porter tank. Your Porter tank has a drain on it. Pete's got it right here. We want to make sure that drain is downhill. Never set up your Porter tank uphill. You never get all the water out of it. A couple other things. Number two, we want to make sure that we're going to take that L-cart BIV connection off. We're going to hook the hard suction straight up to it. Okay. Air is your enemy when you're drafting. So if you have any components that will possibly let air in, you're going to have a hard time getting a draft. So we're going to take that off before we get this Porter tank in our way. Other thing we want to do is when we set this up, we want a diamond coming off of our BIV, okay? So we want just one corner up next to the BIV connection or into our pump. Reason we do that is because then we can add more Porter tanks. So we can go to a double diamond or a triple diamond. What that does, in essence, is it gives more places for all of our tenders to back into. You don't just limit one spot for a tender to drop. You can bring in multiple tenders at a time. By setting up the double diamond, we can then set up a siphoning operation where we can pull from one Porter tank into the next, and we can keep doing that so our tenders will drop into other Porter tanks and not disturb the water that we have on our Porter tank pulling into our apparatus. Third most important thing, remember with these new apparatus with the regen capabilities, that exhaust, if this decides to regen on a seam, will get up to 1200, 1300, 1400 degrees. If you put this Porter tank next to that exhaust, it will melt and you will no longer have a water source. So by setting up that diamond, we're clearing our area away from our exhaust. We're setting ourselves up for further operations, and we're just making the operation simpler by keeping the drain pointed downhill. It's easier to drain. So we're gonna pop this off, get this all set up, and then we'll continue on from there. Okay, one more thing to remember with your Porter tank. Over here on this side, your drain, you need to make sure that that's up and it's actually clipped in. If you don't clip in your drain at the highest point of your Porter tank, you're obviously gonna lose all your water, so make sure that's done. Other components to our setup, now that we've got our Porter tank set up, we got our dry drain on the low side, so it'll be easy to drain. We've got it set up in that diamond, so we're clear of our exhaust and we're setting up for further operations and also making multiple access points for our tenders. Other components you're going to need, we need our hard suction, okay, our 4-inch hard suction. You'll find that on the new apparatus up above the compartments on the officer's side, as well as on the tender, you'll find a hard suction. You can do up to two of these connected at a time. So if you are doing a static water source and you need to lay into a stream, hook two of these up, lay it out to where you need to. At the other end, you need some sort of strainer. This is a low-level strainer, okay? We have this and a barrel strainer. Okay, our barrel strainer is when we're setting into a static water source such as a stream where we're not worried about low levels letting air into our hose line. We can set our low level, our strainer, our barrel strainer up, and all that's preventing is debris coming into our pump. The low level strainer is designed for a water source that could drop down to a lower level. As the water level drops down onto your low level strainer, this allows, instead of a large hole, large 4-inch hole, this will just make all your water have to come in through this lower level, so it allows us to drop this down as low as we need to. So on this setup, we're gonna take our low level strainer, we're gonna tie it into the end of our hard suction, we're gonna take our female end, tie it into our pump, we're gonna get our quarter tank nice and close, and then we're gonna fill this up with water so we can start drafting. When I talk about drafting, air is our enemy. Have your rubber mallet. Any connection that you make on this apparatus needs to be airtight. So when you, after you finish hooking up this 4-inch, give it a couple good hits. Make sure that gasket seats nice and tight so we don't allow any air in. All of your discharges you need to go through, make sure they're all nice and tight. We don't want any loose hose lines, any loose caps, any loose plugs that allow air in. Once you get air in the system, you'll lose your draft and you'll have a hard time getting it back. Okay, so we've got our setup ready. We got our hard suction tied into our pump. We've made sure that we have a airtight pump. We've checked all of our discharges. We've checked all of our intakes. We've also want to check, make sure all of our drains are closed. We lay this in. We got our low level strainer. We got this line hooked up that's gonna go in. We're using that as a circulation line so we can maintain our draft. So we're always moving water. If at any point you stop moving water in a drafting operation, you'll lose your draft and have to start over. So this line, all this is gonna do is kind of help maintain that draft. Key to that though, if you look inside the porter tank here, is make sure those two connections, the intake and the discharge, are as far away from each other as we can make them. If we're pushing water in, that water is naturally gonna put a little bit of air into our tank, and as we suck that air in, again, air is our enemy, it's gonna mess this up. So make sure that those are away from each other. We got our porter tank set up in our diamond shape. We got our tender set up so we can lay our water in. One last note, when you're getting ready to fill these up, once you have your porter tank set up where you want it, you have your drain downhill, you have all this set up, make sure you go around the edges and tuck in this porter tank all the way against the frame. Make sure it's not pinched under the frame and make sure that it's set where you want it before you fill it with water. That amount of water, that amount of weight, when this starts moving, we're gonna cause friction with the ground, we're gonna make holes inside of our porter tank, and then we're gonna have a bad porter tank, we're gonna lose all of our water. So check all your connections, check all your corners before you lay any water. Okay, one more thing before we get going on our draft. We want to make sure that 2.5 recirc line, it could be 1¾ inches, it doesn't matter, but our recirc line, we want to make sure that it's weighted down somehow. So if you look inside here, I know it's hard to see with the water, but we actually anchored it under the low level strainer, and then to have it discharged over here, you can see where the water's bubbling up right here. Again, the key to that is, we want our intake and our discharge opposite of each other, because if this is pushing into our intake, it's gonna just push air in there and we're gonna lose our draft. So make sure it's anchored down, make sure they're at opposite ends of the porter tank. The other thing you can do is once this level starts lowering down with the water, you'll start seeing water tornadoes, and all that is that heavy Venturi effect is trying to suck water in, because it's trying to suck air in, it's moving so much water so quickly. One thing you might see, or you might do, take a tennis ball, some sort of object, throw it in here so it just sits here and floats, and what it'll do is it'll naturally go to that water tornado for you and break it, so that way you don't get any water in your pump. Okay, so we've got our water inside of our porter tank. As you can tell, this 4-inch is kind of floating because it's all filled with air. We'll go up there and we'll learn how to pump it, so that way we know how to pull a draft. We've got our recirculation line in. We're ready to go with this operation. Remember, this is a 1500 GPM pump. Okay, that is rated at a draft, which is what we're doing. So when you're on a scene, you're pulling a draft, you're getting ready to flow water. As an engineer, an acting engineer, you need to keep track of how much water you're flowing. Are you flowing a master stream at 1000 GPM? Are you flowing a hand light at 160? You can't go above 1500. As well as you need to keep track, you and your company officer or incident command needs to keep track. We're gonna burn through this water quick. This is only about 1500 gallons of water. We're gonna go through that quick. So we need more tenders coming. We need to set up a water shuttle. We need to get all those things in place before you start putting someone into an IDLH atmosphere or whatever the case might be. We need to make sure we have the water there.
All right, so we'll go up on the pump panel. I'm gonna walk you through it, and then I'll show you real time.
Our Porter tank set up. We've got our 4-inch hose line in there with our low level strainer. We've gone around, we've checked the entire rig to make sure it's airtight, discharges, drains, intakes, all that stuff set up, we're ready to go. So at this point, what we would do is that we'd engage our pump. Remember, when you wanna get all this set up before you turn your pump on, because right now we have a dry pump, right? Because we've opened up that BIV, there's no water in there. So make sure all this is set up, engage your pump, and then get on the pump panel and pull your draft. If you sit there and let the pump spin dry, it's gonna heat up all those components. Then you're gonna hit it with cold water, you're gonna break the pump. So make sure you get all set up, prepped, engage your pump. Once you come up to the pump panel, the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna put our TPG governor control into RPM mode. Go into RPM mode. Remember, RPM mode we do when we draft, and we do when we're the source pumper on a relay pump. So we're gonna leave it in RPM mode. The first thing I like to do when I pull a draft is that recirculation line going into my Porter tank, which right on this one is discharge 3. I would crack discharge 3 just a little bit. Remember, you always have to have water moving or else we'll never get a draft and we'll always lose our draft. So I'm gonna crack that first. I'm gonna have this in RPM mode. The preferred way of doing this is simply by pushing our Trident air pump, our Trident air primer. When I push that, it's gonna suck the air out of the pump, which is gonna naturally displace with the water inside the Porter tank up the 4-inch hose. I'm gonna sit here and hold that. You can hold this up to 45 seconds at a time. It'll usually take maybe 15, 20 seconds. I'll physically see my 4-inch hose drop down in the water as it weighs itself down with water. And then I'll get instantaneously, this will drop into the negatives, showing that I have a suction. And then my pump discharge is gonna go up because I'm trying to move water. At that point, I'll stop hearing the air move and I'll hear water inside my primer. And I'll see these gauges start to move and I know I have a prime. I'll let go of that, I'll increase that a little bit, and then I can go to work on my draft. I have a draft, I can start moving water. The other way to think of, if your primer's not working for whatever reason, it's broken, it's not functioning properly, whatever the case might be, we do the exact same operation. I come up, I put my TPG into RPM mode, I crack my recirculation discharge a little bit. However, this time I'm gonna come over to my tank to pump, I'm gonna open my tank to pump all the way. The reason I do this is because I have 500 gallons of onboard water. That water is going to backflow into my pump. It's going to backflow down my 4-inch into the Porter tank. Then naturally, I'm pushing all that air into the Porter tank. The air comes up and out. Now I have the system full. I'll slowly shut my tank to pump. Once I see that hose sink down, I'll slowly shut my tank to pump while I increase my pressure governor a little bit. And then again, you'll see these gauges start to move. I'll pull a suction, I'll get discharge pressure, I'll shut my tank to pump, and I'll open up that. Now I got a draft, I'm ready to go. I always leave my recirculation valve open, or at least cracked, so I'm circulating water. And then I close this, and then the first thing I wanna do is make sure that I fill up my tank with whatever water I just used to get that drafting operation. So two different methods. Again, the Trident air primer, or any sort of air primer, is the number one method. It's the easiest, it's the simplest. However, if that's not functioning, we can always go to the tank to pump method and it's gonna do the exact same thing. All right, so we're gonna start our pump operation. I got my pump in gear. Remember, you don't wanna just run your pump and sit here and mess around getting your stuff set up. Get all your stuff set up, get your pump in gear, and then go right into drafting operations. Because remember, our pump doesn't have any water in it right now. When you turn your pump on, it's turning, it's heating up everything inside the pump, and then we hit it with cold water, we're just gonna destroy stuff. So get it all set up, get ready to go, and then get going on your pump. Okay, so I'm on discharge 3. Again, I'm gonna go into RPM mode. I always say in RPM mode when I'm drafting. I'm gonna crack discharge 3 just a little bit, okay, because that's where I want my water to go. Again, a few different ways I could do it. I could either push and hold the primer, and you can watch water come right into my pump. You can hear the water noise go away. I can hear water and I automatically see pump discharge pressure go up. I have a draft. I can then kick it up to whatever I need. I can look and make sure that I do have water going in. You pull the draft, that's it. Again, I keep this cracked at all times, because I never want to lose my draft. I always want water moving. and now I can set up my operation. So if I want to go to the deck gun, I make sure everybody's clear, and I have water. We pump as normal after that, make sure we stay in RPM mode, making sure we watch our water tank level, always circulating water, always moving water, never water hammer anything. I'll never lose my draft because I got it going. Again, the other way of doing that, instead of pushing my primer, is all I gotta do is crack my tank fill. You'll see that same operation. You'll see that 4-inch sink. You'll see water bubbling up because I'm losing that air. And then I slowly close that and it'll automatically pull a draft. Again, any questions about any of this, Fleet 2, training, call myself, talk to an engineer, whatever you need to do. We're here to help. That's as simple as drafting it.